Welcome to another tutorial by The Ghost. In this one, I'm just going to tell you about aphids. And the thing about aphids is that they cause splash damage, okay? So, in this video, you're going to see a man, G-Gamer, or I don't know if it's female or male, but they're going to get taken out by an aphid, okay? And they're hiding behind cover. Look, they're against the wall, okay? They're against the wall like they should be. And they're doing what they should be as far as protecting themselves against other bots, okay? So, if you know you're injured, so I don't know the damage, but I know they're missing a weapon. So, obviously, they're damaged. They're picking up the beacon, but they're trying to stay close to the wall, okay? That's their goal. And this has happened to me, especially on Springfield. I've been in Springfield, and like, right on the corner, and I get killed. I'm like, how in the world did I get killed? Well, the thing about aphids is that they actually do splash damage. So if you ever notice somebody shooting aphids at you and you have a shield, if you see it on a rhino, rhinos have a shield, but they can't block splash. So when the rhino takes damage from an aphid, that lets you know the aphid does splash damage. Okay, when you fire your weapon at a Raijin, Raijins don't take damage from energy, but they take damage from splash. If you do damage, you're doing splash damage. So the aphid actually does splash damage. That's what makes it so deadly, because not only does it hurt you if it hits you, it hurts you even if it doesn't hit you. So in this situation here, you're going to see my man, Curtit, I guess is how you say it, with the gun in his name, is going to fire at my boy or my girl, G-Gamer, but it say G-Man, right? So let's say G-Man. We're going to go with a man. We're going to say it's a man, all right? They're going to fire at them, and when they fire at them, now look at this. Boom, look how far back they jump. Now, here's the thing. A lot of times, people with aphids who've been playing with them for a while, they actually will jump to get better range on you and also get their weapons up higher. So they get them high up enough, they'll actually hit the top of the building and kind of simply go over the building slightly, and they can still kill you. And so this was a calculated move. You see they jump. This wasn't by mistake. They did this on purpose, right? And so now as you watch what comes out. They jump, they're jumping, and then you're going to see weapons come out. And it's going to be aphids, and I believe they have spirals as well, but I think they just have aphids. Let's see. Okay, yeah, boom, just the top. So all they had were aphids. They had two aphids on the top, and you're just going to see them puppies come in. And they're coming in hot, baby. They're coming in hot. There they are. Now, as they come in, you're going to see my man. I'm going to turn around to a terrible sight. A terrible sight. And this has happened to me, and I didn't see it, right? I just know I got hit by some aphids. Look to the right. At the top, it just said aphid, and it says G-Man Gamer, and look, they're going down. So they were behind the wall, they were hiding like they were supposed to, trying to use that wall for cover. But what the person did on the other side, which was a great move, they jumped to give their aphids that range in the air, and then they hit them, because it's hard to get aphids over certain areas. But when you jump, look how much distance he covered, okay? So he definitely had a 350, because right now I have him targeted, so it's at 274, right? He's well within his range, but he knew this person was low on health, and all he wanted to do was get maybe, if he could get just one or two of them over the top of that wall, he might kill him, and it worked out for him. So if you have aphids, just know you can actually use your griffin. If they're on your griffin, you can elevate and you can try to fire over a wall and get them just high enough where instead of them hitting the top of the wall, they kind of get slightly over, and aphids explode, right? They have a splash radius, and that splash radius killed my man G-Man Gamer. And I've been killed by it before, so just understand aphids are not fun to play around with, but if you're using them, learning little techniques like that can get a bot out of there. So let's say I wasn't here. He just got a bot out the way, so now he can come over and get this beacon from us. But I was actually near that beacon already, so now I can actually challenge him. So this is The Ghost. I hope this has been informative to you. I definitely need to put that in regular motion so you can see it. Let me jump around. I'm jumping around, man. Jumping around. All right, so that was my man G-Man. That looks so funny. It looked like he'd been hit already. All right, let's go back. That's funny the way that was paused. So let's look at this in regular motion so you can see. And we want to make sure we're always doing regular motion. And screen look kind of weird. There's a jump. And fire. And boom. G-Man Gamer down. Okay, so it wasn't the guy to the right. It was the one we were looking at. They fired that shot and took him out. And they used the height of the Griffin to actually do it. So just remember that you can get your aphids over certain structures just by elevating your body if you're on a Griffin. Okay, this is the Ghost Man. This is the Ghost Man teaching not only you, but myself as well, baby. Talk to you later. Deuces.
Thanks for watching. Leave a comment if you enjoyed this video. And as always, choose like over death.